Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Probably never thought y'all ever see me again, huh? Well, life is lifing. That's the best way I can put it. Life has been lifing for quite a while, but today is Wednesday, January the 3rd. I am actually off of work today, so I figured why not go ahead and restart the vlog. I wanted so badly to restart on Monday the 1st, but I literally, my list was a laundry list of stuff. So I didn't even wanna. Anyway, I'm doing OMED all year. Yes, I'm gonna try my absolute best. I've actually been keeping up with OMED. I'm doing really good. I did weigh in on the 1st. I should have took a snapshot of that, but I was never been one. I was 238, I believe. So 238, and I think the last time I weighed in, I was somewhere in the 250s. So not bad. I've been doing really good. I've really been, you know, keeping up with OMED and just trying to stick to one meal a day. And even though it hasn't been keto OMED, like when I first started out, it's still showing that OMED is working for me. So I'm very happy about that for sure. So today I'm gonna skip with all the life updates right now. I'm sure we'll get into that in another video, but you guys clicked on this to see the OMED meals and I cannot wait to show you guys. So on Instagram, I came across a young lady's channel. I've been getting so much inspo from Instagram where she made a loaded cauliflower, like a loaded mashed cauliflower. And I was like, okay, I'm not necessarily doing keto, but I am trying to keep, you know, my carbohydrates low. So maybe a low carb lifestyle, low carb diet. So I said, oh, okay, that sounds great. So me and my husband actually prepped some veggies last night. Yes, meal prep is still the thing. We prepped some veggies last night. I did 2 heads of cauliflower and they are on sale, which is great. So yeah, let's go ahead and make this cauliflower. She basically just boiled it, boiled the cauliflower, and then she popped it in her blender. So I have my NutriBullet blender already prepped and ready to go, washed out and cleaned. So I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna boil this, whip it on up. I'm gonna add in, I have butter here. I think I have some leftover buttermilk ranch dip that I'm gonna add in there. I'm probably gonna do some, of course, some seasonings, like, you know, garlic powder, onion powder, all that good stuff. I also have some sour cream. And then I have a bevy of cheeses. So I have a sharp cheddar, and then I also have a medium cut thick cheddar, or thick cut medium cheddar, and then a thick cut white mild cheddar. So I'm basically just gonna be doing cheese, sour cream, this dip, butter. I also have just a few pieces of leftover bacon. So I'm gonna go ahead and just kind of chop that up. And then I also have some green onions that I have in the refrigerator that I'm also gonna use for that as well. So we are literally gonna be making a loaded cauliflower for, you know, as a portion of our meal for our one meal a day. So that's what I'm gonna do to attempt to do today. In the meantime, in between time, I also have veggies that, like I mentioned, me and my husband actually prepped last night. It looks great. I even threw in a couple jalapenos there. Yeah, so some peppers, some zucchini, some jalapenos. I also have in this second little tray, this one was some red onions, some of those green onions that I still have waiting in the fridge, and then also some of those little grape tomatoes. So I'm really gonna make a nice colorful array of roasted vegetables. Yeah, them onions is heavy. Roasted vegetables. Alrighty guys, so to start with this cauliflower, I'm gonna go ahead and pop this in my pot. This is my new pot. This is from Ninja. So Ninja Foodie, I believe it's the Never Stick. Ninja Foodie Never Stick. I mean, I actually love the bottom of this pan. Super cute. But the Ninja Foodie Never Stick, they sent me over, Lord, an 11 piece set. Which I appreciate. So that is what I'm going to be using. They sent that over for in exchange for my honest review through Influencer. So I'm going to be trying out the pot or portion today to go ahead and just boil that cauliflower. I'm not exactly sure how long to boil it, but I'll be checking it. I'm sure when it's tender, I'll just go ahead and pop it in there. So let's go ahead and get to it. butter. It wasn't a whole stick, but yeah, I don't put that in. Put in the rest of this ranch dip. It wasn't a whole bunch, but it definitely give it some flavor. I'm also gonna do some of the sour cream. So we're gonna add in the spices. We're gonna start with a little bit of onion powder, garlic powder, because I love garlic mashed potatoes myself. Do some garlic salt. So a little bit of adobo seasoning, and I mean a little bit because I also put in that ranch, that leftover ranch, so I don't want it to be too, what's the word, like too salty at all. All right, I'm also gonna do some fresh cracked black pepper. I actually need to re-up on some more. In case it needs a little help to kind of move around, I'm gonna just use it a little bit of this half and half. But in the meantime, I am gonna just add in some sharp cheddar. That, maybe about a cup or so. So that's about a cup. All right, so I'm gonna pop this on. Ooh, Lord, let's hope that this works out well. So let me turn this on, boop, boop, boop. Let's put it on medium. So it needs a little help. So I'm gonna open this up and add in a little bit of this half and half. Let me show you. But the bottom looks like it'll be okay. Let's see, I just wanna incorporate everything. Just a little bit. Cause no one wants mushy. There's a piece of cheese there. I know I don't want no mushy. Okay, let's try that again. Medium. Okay. Well, I had to put it on high, but it looks like it actually mixed it all up. Ooh. It actually smells like potatoes. I think it might be the cheese. All right, let me grab my spoon here. All right, and let's, what else? I like the vegetable. Ooh, those are, just a little bit of mixing it needs to do, but these are definitely very, ooh, I mean bad. I wish I had kept, maybe not boiled it so much. Not too bad at all. All right. So yeah, maybe next time keep a little bit of texture to it. But it is definitely a whipped, almost like a whipped potato, but I can't even taste the cauliflower. That's what's so funny. I can't even taste the cauliflower portion of it. But yeah, that's what it looks like, and it tastes like everything, which is great. So when I add a little bit of that bacon and that green onion, ooh, that's gonna be delicious. All right, guys, so I am actually sitting down. It is maybe about 12 minutes to 2 to break my fast. And of course, the star of the show was my cauliflower, loaded mashed cauliflower. Even though it wasn't mashed, it was kind of blended, and it definitely got blended a lot more than what it should have been. It's almost kind of like a soup or a really thick puree. But either way, it tasted delicious when I tasted it. And then I also added a little bit of cheese on top, some crumpled up bacon that we still had left, and also some fresh green onions, spring onions, and then some cracked black pepper. My husband took me out for a steak dinner on Saturday, so I still have some steak left. Along with that, I also had some Brussels sprouts, which are just kind of like this little dark mass here. And then some of those fresh veggies that we roasted in the oven. I just kind of got a scoop of those. They're still roasting, but it's okay. It's going to all blend together and be delicious. I still have a little bit, or actually a pretty decent sized piece of my ribeye left over, and it is still juicy, as you can see. So that is what I will be having to break my fast. I left Muggy. I'm sorry, guys. There is no more Muggy. Muggy, actually, I was in an Uber and I took my coffee one day and I left it in the Uber. Never got it back. Did not realize that I had left it in the Uber until, yeah, I was fully in my destination, everything. And I was like, oh crap, I left my Muggy. Like, how did I leave that? I gotta get a Muggy replacement. But for right now, this little tumbler will work perfectly. I just did some coffee, some dark roast, which I usually do. And then I actually added in, I'm still doing protein coffee. So I did my Atkins mocha latte protein shake into my coffee so that I have a little something to kind of hold me over. And of course I have my water cup here, which you guys already saw me refill. And then I added in my immunity stuff. So I actually just juiced some lemons. As you can see, the juice, it was back there. I juiced some lemons and I also juiced some ginger. And I like to have that around, you know, the colder months, because it literally helps to keep you well. Like, everyone I know is literally getting sick and I am over here thriving. So hopefully it'll stay that way. But yeah, literally everyone came back to work off holiday and they are literally sick. So I am trying my best to stay as healthy as I possibly can. I am in a wedding this weekend, just to kind of give you guys a little brief rundown of my week. I'm in a wedding this weekend. I have an assembly or an event on Sunday. So it is literally going to be just probably pictures or short videos of what I am going to be breaking my fast with. But for today's Wednesday, so Thursday, at least Thursday, you're going to see, you know, what I break my fast with. But for right now, this is today. I'm so sorry, guys. It's probably the worst time to start off a vlog. But again, I was inspired and just wanted to go ahead and reach out to you guys and say hello and tell you guys that I missed you guys and your comments so much, and that I'm trying my best to come back. So hopefully I can facilitate that. Hopefully I can actually do that. So thank you guys so much for joining me. Thank you so much. If you guys like the recipe, try it out. I will also have the young lady's Instagram link below. We're here, baby. OMAD all year. So yeah, get into it. I will see you guys next time in my, I'll see y'all tomorrow when I break my fast. But until then, stay good. And I hope you guys are doing well for 2024. Give this video a humongous thumbs up. And of course, don't forget to subscribe if you are new. Take care, guys. Bye. Hey, guys. Welcome back to my channel. Today is Thursday. It is January the 4th. And I am just now getting home. It is 5:14. So I need to get on the ball with getting food and stuff. But I just had a few appointments that I needed to take care of today besides work. I was actually able to stop and grab a Starbucks. It was right there by my where I needed to have my appointment. So I grabbed me this one's not a dark roast. Unfortunately, they didn't have it super late in the day. They actually just had a pike. I think it was pike, which is their medium roast. Either way, I just got it black. So I'm going to add my own little creamer and my own little Splenda and stuff like that for that. So that's what I'll be having. So I'll give you guys a brief update. I am now a couponer. Don't ask me why, but I think it's a great way to kind of save on some of the household essentials that you need, like detergent. I mainly see detergent and paper products and toothpaste and stuff like that that we use on a regular basis. So I picked up some paper towels. And we definitely go through paper towels in our households. So I got a 6-pack of these Bounty Essentials paper towels from the Walgreens. This week they were on sale for $5.49. I had a $1 off coupon on the Walgreens app, which made it $4.49. And then on Ibotta, I submitted for a $4 back. So Ibotta had it for like a $4 cash back. So I got these paper towels for 49 cents. So yes, I'm very proud of my small but my mighty haul today. That was 49 cents for a 6-pack of paper towels. You cannot beat that. So I'm happy about that. Alrighty guys, so besides making my coffee the way I would like it with all of the, you know, accoutrement items in there, I'm also gonna have, I think what we have left is burgers. I think that's all we have left in here is burgers. And some, and that cauliflower mix that I made yesterday, and then some of the veggies that I roasted as well. So I'm gonna incorporate all of that. And I wanted to try these kimchi flavored noodles by a company called, I guess it's Mama. I went to the Asian market the other day, and when I went in there just to kind of peruse around, I happened to see these, and they were just like, you know, regular pack of, you know, regular oodles and noodles, but, and it was the kimchi flavor, and I really do like kimchi, so I was like, you know what, let me try this out. I'm sure this is probably the worst thing ever for me, but I'm just gonna do one pack. So I'm gonna go ahead and boil and make this pack of noodles to go along with my hamburger that I have in here, and along with the, cauliflower puree basically that I made, because it's definitely not mashed, and those veggies that I made yesterday, I roasted off. I made my little self some noodles. I'm excited to try these out, especially the kimchi flavored. I cannot wait because it is freezing cold here, and something hot and steamy like that is perfect. So I forgot all about the meatballs that I had taken out of the freezer. Usually when I make meatballs in like a big amount, I kind of just freeze them and save them for later. And I forgot that I had taken them out and thawed them and all that good stuff. So I have one burger. I have some of that loaded, so y'all can see that loaded cauliflower mash that I made yesterday. Some, I did like 6 meatballs on my plate and just reheated that. And that's just in some like regular marinara sauce. So nothing, I didn't need anything too juicy. And then all of those wonderful roasted veggies. Oh my goodness, right on top is gonna just put this over the top. So I may not be able to eat all of it, but I'm definitely digging in because I am hungry and cold. Two terrible things for me to feel. So I did, as you guys could see, I added in some zero sugar French vanilla creamer. And then of course my favorite, which is the Atkins, the mocha latte protein in here. So I can just have a little something, a sweet treat at the end of my meal, kind of bring everything together. And hopefully this will hold me over till tomorrow. Now tomorrow sparks the start of the wedding weekend. I mentioned to you guys yesterday that I am in a wedding this weekend. So I'm not gonna be able to sit down and talk with you guys, unfortunately, but I am gonna still show you the food, and I will also put in the time frame in which I broke my fast. So right now it is 5:31 p.m. I'm about to dig in as soon as I say goodbye, but I will see you all again next week in another weekly vlog. So you guys take care, and I will see you then. Don't forget, of course, to like this video and, of course, subscribe. And if there's someone that you know that can benefit from it, don't be afraid to share it. Take care, guys. Quick update, it is Sunday, it is 2:57 p.m. I just got back from my assembly where I needed to be at, and I just grabbed something really quickly from Georgia Peach. I just got their wing combo along with mac and cheese and string beans. Please forgive the way I sound. I do not feel my best. I hope I'm not getting sick, but I think it's just post-nasal drip, so... I just wanted to eat something comforting, and I'm about to go lay my tail down. So this is what I had. We got home safely from the wedding. Everything was great this weekend, but I just wanted to give you guys a quick update before I start next week's vlog. But I hope you guys had a great week, and I cannot wait to see you again. Take care. Bye.